Hey there, AI Ian. Have you seen this photo of the Pope in a Balenciaga puffer jacket? It's all over the internet.
Yes, I did, Ian. I know a lot of people were fooled by that one. But really, it's easy to spot this kind of fake content.
How did you know it wasn't real?
Well, it seemed kind of out of character to me, so I did a quick reverse image search. And guess what? It brought me right to a Reddit post. In a community for Midjourney AI-generated images.
That's crazy. This technology is getting more advanced every day. So time to find out, is this legit? Hi everyone, it's me, the real Ian, and welcome back to another episode of Is This Legit? A series brought to you by MediaWise and PBS Student Reporting Labs, where we fact check viral misinformation and teach you ways that you can do it on your own. So what just happened there? Well, this was a conversation between a human, me, and an AI-generated version of me, read by my voice clone. Nope, this isn't some sci-fi fantasy. Now that we're being bombarded with synthetic images, AI-generated text, and now voice cloning, it's time to learn how to not be fooled by this technology. First, a little bit about voice cloning. A company called ElevenLabs' voice synthesis platform lets users generate realistic audio of any person's voice by uploading a few minutes of audio samples and typing in text for it to say. This is what produced viral clips you might have heard, such as a fake Emma Watson reading Mein Kampf. Synthetic voices have come a long way since their inception, evolving from basic robotic tones to incredibly realistic and personalized voices. In fact, the latest synthetic voices are becoming almost indistinguishable from natural speech. In order to create a clone voice, the computer needs two things: the words we want it to read and a sample of voice we want it to sound like. This Medium article gives a clear example. If we wanted Batman to read the phrase, "I love pizza," then we give the system two things: text that says, "I love pizza," and a short sample of Batman's voice, so it knows what Batman should sound like. The output should then be an audio of Batman's voice saying the words, "I love pizza."
I love pizza.
As cool as this sounds, it's obvious that this has some pretty serious misinformation capabilities. A bad actor could use AI voice cloning to create a recording of a politician, journalist, or other public figure saying something they never actually did. This AI-generated clip was supposedly of Joe Biden mocking transgender people. Really offensive. Now let's get back to the Pope in a puffer jacket. This is an example of AI-generated images. Same deal as with audio, but with realistic-looking images. Seriously, these things are getting so realistic, you can barely tell something created with AI from a real photo. Like voice cloning, AI-generated images also have the potential for misinformation. For example, that fake mugshot of former President Trump you may have seen. I did a reverse image search to try to find the original source of the pic. Media literacy is all about understanding context. So, what can you do to avoid being duped by any kind of AI-generated content? The first thing you want to do when you see suspicious images or hear any sus audio is investigate the user who posted it. Back to the Pope again. Do a keyword search for the username, display name, or any other tidbits from the user's bio. Doesn't look like a Vatican photographer, and neither their Twitter nor Instagram provides any evidence that they are a trustworthy source. But you should always go deeper. Next, try to find out where the image or audio came from. For images, try a reverse image search. This is when you use a search engine to find similar or identical images. It might get you to the original source. A search for the Pope image took us to a Reddit post in a community for Midjourney AI-generated images. For audio, do a keyword search for an exact quote, and if nothing pops up, despite it seeming newsworthy, that's a red flag. Pay attention to any quirks or inconsistencies in the voice or the image. The audio might have unusual pauses or changes in pitch or tone. It might sound slightly robotic or unnatural. So listen to a little of these fake newscasters who sound very stilted.
I am a computer-generated person that doesn't exist in reality.
Hello, everyone. I'm an English artificial intelligence anchor.
For images, look closely at hands, eyeglasses, and teeth. Are there too many fingers? Then zoom in on the background. Are the faces just blurry blobs? Use voice recognition tools that can help you determine if a recording has been artificially generated. Here's the thing, AI-generated content is getting better and better every day. The best tactic you might take is simply the trusty keyword search. If the recording or image looks suspicious, try to confirm it with other sources before accepting it as true. Cross-reference the information with other news sources, official statements, or trusted experts in the field. For example, it was pretty simple to confirm that the images of Donald Trump's mugshot were actually fake. And whatever you do, don't share or forward any recordings or images without first verifying their authenticity. And now, back to AI Ian.
I think that about wraps it up. Be sure to subscribe to MediaWise for more fact checks and tips. Bye, guys.
Don't compromise, be MediaWise.